Heyo, my name is Mini Shadow, and welcome to my guide on Orc Lord. The Orc Lord has just under 5,000 HP, and there will be a quest requirement, which we will be doing. You do not have to bring any switches when facing this boss, as his divination protection changes quite frequently. When doing the quest, we will be required to enter a PvP area for a short moment, however, we will be teleporting out as soon as we can. Alright, you'll want to bring your best weapons and armor as we will be fighting a boss. Don't forget your mana and arrows. If you would like, you can bring some magic, archery, or strength stat boosting potions, as well as defense may help. If you have the level, bring some divination potions as well for faster kills. I recommend bringing a bunny helmet as it reduces the travel time, and you can fill the rest of your inventory with fish. The start of the quest and the entrance to the Orc Lord is located right here. However, we do not have to go there in order to get the items we need to complete the quest. So let's gather those. We need to get 4 ancient artifacts, and we can do so by going east out of Mudwich towards the desert. Or you can teleport there. However, we're going to save our teleport. Upon entering the desert, we are going to head north towards a cave, where we will find our first artifact. Entering the cave, you'll want to immediately start heading northeast, east as much as you can, and then north. It's right here in the corner. Here is ancient artifact number 1. Nice. Alright, let's head on out of the cave. After you exit, you'll want to head directly south, as far as you can go. Continuing past the entrance, just past the graveyard will be our second artifact down here in the corner. There it is. With the second under our belt, we can head on over towards the third, which is located in a PvP area, being the anthill. To get there, head east. We'll be teleporting out of this location once we get the ancient artifact. Just up this ramp is where the Orc Lord is located and the quest start. Moving past that, we can start heading north, and the anthill will be headed just to the east down this ladder. Entering the PvP area, we will immediately head east and enter the first ladder we see to the north. That is the one. Heading down the ladder, the third artifact will be located just to the south. Pick it up and you can teleport out of here to the desert. When you arrive, head north and then east into the door. After you enter, continue south, and then through the door to the west. After exiting your ladder door, head south. And your last and final 4th artifact will be here. With all of them in hand, we can head back to the Orc Lord or quest start area, which requires us to go through our door ladder. Head north once more and back through the door. Look at this pesky little mouse dude getting in our way. Good thing we can right-click walk here. After leaving, head directly south. East a little bit, and then south once more. Heading through the cliff entrance here, A little bit to the east, you will see the NPC to the north. This is where you'll hand in your four artifacts, and the door to the Orc Lord will appear to the north there. When you're ready, head on in. Now, there is a chance that the Orc Lord could be directly on the other side of this door if another player encountered them and has run away, but that happens very rarely. Continue heading down south and then east towards this path. Around the bend and south a little bit more is where the boss will be. This is where I recommend you activate all your buffs, drink your potion, set your divination, and head on further in. When you're ready, click on the Orc Lord and you will begin the encounter. He will run to you and attack from melee. Now, each of his melee hits has a chance to poison you. The poison damage you'll receive is quite minimal. You can ignore this mechanic entirely. The next mechanic is the Orc Lord will spawn adds throughout the fight. If you have high defense and good armor, you can ignore this as well. If you have lower stats and armor, feel free to kite the boss in a circle and you will take zero damage. You can do this while using magic or ranged by moving with WASD and clicking the boss frame up at the top. And with that, the Orc Lord goes down. GG, buddy. Let's take a look at what the Orc Lord drops, shall we? Let's head on over to his drop log. On the list is the Golden Shovel, Ancient Shovel, Bat Sword, Chaos Wand, Colossal Chest Piece, Leg Plates, Helmet, as well as the Boots, and Shield. After that, we have the Best in Slot Tank Necklace for melee. As you can see, there is quite a lot that this boss drops. Many useful things like the Golden Shovel that gives you 4 sand per dig, or the Best in Slot Tank gear for melee. Look at this baguette, dude. Isn't it glorious? As always, if you found this video helpful, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Take care.